I'm here with epidemiologist Bonny Specker, who is going to give us an epidemiology 101, Epi 101 mini lesson today about herd immunity. Bonny, what can you tell us about herd immunity?
Yes, thanks, Chelsea. There are a lot of people talking about herd immunity and thinking it might be a good idea if people just became sick with COVID so that they could become immune. And if enough people did that, then everything would be okay. I want to go through just a couple things. Here we have a population. Each one of these big squares represents a population. And the green dots are people who are not immune to the disease. And we have this infected person that comes into that population. And they spread the disease. Other people become sick. This person develops some immunity. And over time, we have a large percent of the population becoming sick, and eventually a large percent of them with immunity. So now you take this population and you insert someone who's infected, and it's really much more difficult for that person to transmit the disease because there's all these immune people sort of in the way between them and the ones that are not immune. Now, when people talk about herd immunity, what we really want to emphasize is that for the most part, we want that to occur through vaccination, not through having the disease. If a high percent of the population is immune, that will protect the most vulnerable populations. There are people out there that can't get vaccinated. So that's the purpose or the rationale for herd immunity and the goal of vaccination programs. Herd immunity for COVID right now is estimated to be at about 60 to 85%. So that's how much of the population would have to be immune to COVID to give the population herd immunity so that the disease could no longer transmit. There are a couple important considerations. First, reaching herd immunity with a vaccine really is the best way. And currently, there is no vaccine for COVID. And the infection is the only way to achieve immunity. But it's, you know, there have been reports out lately saying that it's not really clear how long natural immunity may last with COVID. There are reports of people getting ill with COVID more than once. And there are also reports that antibodies appear to decrease over time. And this is controversial, where here we have one article saying that though some of those reports might be overblown, they are based on not a lot of numbers, but just so that people realize we don't even know how long you'll be immune to this disease. So you don't want to base everything you're doing on that. Another thing is that there may be long-term lingering consequences if you become sick with COVID. And there have been a lot of reports the last couple months about heart problems. And I think we did that on a previous Epi 101 mini lesson. There, you know, may be permanent heart damage or heart damage for some period of time, as well as neurological deficits that can occur in people that have had COVID. And this is an area, again, that not a lot of people know about, and they're still doing a lot of research. Another important consideration is that the estimated number of deaths among South Dakotans would not be small if herd immunity was obtained through infections. And I just calculated this out. For if we take that 60% or 85% that I had mentioned earlier that would be needed for herd immunity. And I looked at these three age groups because I figured this is students, college students, their parents, and their grandparents' ages. How many deaths would we expect in those age groups? Well, if we go up to 85% of the population developing COVID, what you see is though there won't be that many, but 92 is significant, I think, if one of them is your friend. In the 20 to 29 year old age group, 1,200 parents are going to die and close to 3,000 grandparents. If you look at all ages combined, you would have about 14,000 deaths in South Dakota if 85% of the population developed COVID, which is one of the estimates of what percent would be required to have that herd immunity. So if you're going for herd immunity through getting infected, you're going to have a large number of deaths. So it would be best to just wait for the vaccine. Oh, and one thing I also want to mention about this case fatality rate here, this is the percent of individuals who die that are sick with COVID. And these numbers are actually based on what we have observed in South Dakota. So these are not data outside of South Dakota. You know, we have seen deaths in that 20 to 29 year old group, albeit they've been small. And as of August 23rd, South Dakota has had 161 deaths, but only a very small portion of the population has actually tested positive. This is that 20 to 29 year age group. Only 2.3% of South Dakotans in this age group have actually tested positive. So we would have to go from that 2% all the way up to 85%. In order to get herd immunity. And you can see that the older individuals, it's a lower percent. So herd immunity without a vaccine would result in an estimated 10 to 14,000 deaths among South Dakotans. And there would be 350,000 to 500,000 individuals who may have long-lasting health effects if that is what is determined to happen with COVID. So really for now, washing hands and socially distancing remains the best way to prevent deaths and possible long-lasting effects. And at least it will buy us time to develop the vaccines and get herd immunity through vaccination and not through having